are at Gomti Ghat in Dwarka, right at the doorstep of the Dwarkadhish temple. And the temple remains closed for the devotees today. But you can see the swelling in the sea. That is Gomati Sudama Setu. As you can see in front of you, that entire area is shut for people today. You can see that the water of the sea is coming inside, and you know, we have been seeing some tidal activity as well. The shops around these areas have been completely shut. Now remember, this is a town which has its economy running around as a tourist destination, as a devotional place, and that is why the devotees form an important part of this entire economy of the village. Let us try and understand from these people what their problems are. Aaj to sab kuch band karke rakha
hai. Aaj sab kuch band hai. Dwarka mein sab allowed hai. 144 lag gayi hai 3 din ke liye.
तो फिर आप रास्ते पे क्या कर रहे हो?
मैं इलेक्ट्रिक में जॉब करता हूँ, देखने चला था पीजीवीसीएल में, इसलिए आया था।
आज सब कुछ बंद है, मंदिर दुकान?
मंदिर दुकान सभी सभी बंद है, सभी रास्ते में निकलते नहीं है, वो जॉब वाले है वो ही निकलते हैं, दूसरे लोग नहीं निकलते।
कुछ दिक्कत हो रही है इसकी वजह से आपको?
नहीं, दिक्कत तो हो रही है, ये लाइट आ सकती है जा सकती है, क्या करे, हम तो जॉब करते है तो क्या करे।
People here say that it is inconveniencing, that you know, there is some electricity problem as well, and that they are not able to you know, go ahead with their regular activities. But they also seem to understand that these are the warnings that have been issued with respect to the cyclonic conditions that exist here in Dwarka. As of now, Gomti Ghat, which is a prime location for all the devotees coming for the darshan of Dwarkadhish, is completely shut. Roads are deserted. As we can see, the wind speed has only been increasing for the last few hours. In fact, we are here in Dwarka, where we are seeing that continuously the wind flow has been going on and on. As you can see, it's over 60-70 kilometers per hour at the speed at which the winds are flowing. We are here right near the seashore. People have already been evacuated in great numbers, and the rainfall has also begun. Even as Biporjoy is just a few hours, maybe half an hour from the landfall, we can see that you know, the winds have already picked up, and climatically the situation is worsening by every minute. The hotel that you can see right here, we have seen lampposts have fallen. We have seen that several pillars that were standing there have gone to the ground, and also that the glasses have been shattering for quite some time now. If I may request my video journalist Rajesh Sapre to show you what is the impact that Biporjoy is having. The ground situation in Dwarka is absolutely terrible right now. We are being lashed by heavy rains coupled with extremely high flowing winds. The gusty winds have also started. In fact, according to officials here, the wind speed has increased from over 70 kilometers per hour and above. As my video journalist Rajesh Sapre is showing you the visuals, you can see that barely anything is stable right now. It's difficult to stand properly. You know, trees are getting affected. Several pillars have come down. Electricity poles have come down. Even in residential properties, you know, the hotels which are around this beach, glasses have started shattering. We have just some time ago seen lampposts come down. So clearly the destruction caused by Cyclone Biporjoy as it comes closer to landfall is being felt here at Dwarka, from where the winds are also passing in heavy. Heavy winds have also been passing from here. Rains are lashing from almost all directions. There isn't a single specific direction in which the rains are coming from. And the winds have led to a surge. The seas have also started surging. We are closer to the beach, which is barely 50 meters away, but the visibility has got affected so much that it is not possible to see the beach. It's become almost impossible to stand here. The speed at which the winds have been blowing have been quite strong. In fact, it's even difficult to try and keep walking on this location. We are right now in Dwarka, where the speed of winds is making it impossible to even stand at a specific location and hold on to your position. My video journalist Rajesh Sapre and I, both of us, are finding it a bit difficult to keep standing and to keep holding grounds, even as the wind speed due to Cyclone Biparjoy as it comes close to a landfall has only been increasing. Over 75,000 people have been moved to safety till now, is what NDRF says. Of them, close to 10,000 from Dwarka alone, the place where I am right now. Let us try and show you the visuals around this place. This is Dwarka, where you're continuously seeing heavy rainfall. You know, all the pots have come down and fallen and broken. There's a pillar that was standing here, which you can see right now, has come down. The tin sheds that are there on this particular hotel and establishment, we can see that the bamboo which is holding those tarpaulin sheets is already loosening up the flow of the wind as well as the incessant rainfall. You can see the impact of it all due to Cyclone Biparjoy as it comes closer to a landfall. We are right close to the seashore. As you can see, the barricading to the electric box that is there, even that is being shattered. It's being cemented to the ground, but that cement holding is also shattering due to the speed of the winds, as you can see here. So it's becoming increasingly difficult to stand and to give out information of the kind of mayhem that is being caused due to the cyclone. We are just a few meters away from the sea, but the visibility of the sea is also getting affected. If I can request my video journalist to show you, there's a tremendous swell in the sea. We can see the waves from where we are standing. The level of sea has risen in the last half an hour or so.